is a very big thing, especially if you can get, you know, your Soldier 76 up there, something of that nature to just rain down on people sitting up there can be really, really effective.
Yeah, especially throughout the first stage and the second stage. The third stage, I mean, there's some pockets where the high ground really matters, especially before you turn around that corner of the high ground that's up on the high right. But pushing into the final point, it has an impact, but it's not nearly as hard to shut down. In the first stage, you see a lot of teams now going across the bridge through server room, taking the high ground away and kind of turning the tables on defense. And in the second stage, everybody tries to take the shuttle, because if you don't, you can have a nano visor coming in straight through that shuttle, dropping in your backline and cleaning everything up. So you absolutely have to address it. And that's why I think Immortals is going to be a tough team to play on this map.
So, feeling split about who's going to win on Gibraltar. Give me a prediction as we go in the game. Who's winning this match, Renegades or Immortals?
I'll take Immortals here 2-1.
Definitely going 2-1. I'd really want to know what the next maps are. I'm going to go ahead and give it to Renegades, because I think they might have some tricks up their sleeve in the new maps. And if that same old magic that worked for them in the group play, at least what I attribute it to, plays out, then I expect to see them really turn it on a map, perhaps like Eichenwald, Legion. That's going to be great.
Yeah, and that's a great part about going into today, as well as that there is... we do have some different maps in the map pool. Mix things up a little bit from what we've seen over the past couple weeks. Going to try these teams out on some different ones and keep things interesting. You know, because we haven't seen too much of these teams on some of the maps that we've brought into the map pool today, like the Eichenwalds or the Lijiang, things of that nature. So we'll be seeing some different ones. And these teams, of course, had some time to prep for it, so they certainly have... practiced, I'm sure, on some of these different maps. But Gibraltar has been in the pool, and that is what we are going to be seeing first. Renegades will be on the offense. Immortals will be starting on the defensive side as we kick things off here on Gibraltar.
You see Jesus here for Renegades. Just going to get a Sonic. Never mind. That Sonic arrow is not going to go where we want it. But switch off and change over to Soldier 76 anyways. Immortals actually playing a little bit forward on the high ground, something we haven't seen so much about. Looks like that's just a little bit of early vision. They're going to back off to server room.
Yeah, just a quick little bit of poke. Build up every little percent of alt that you can, but Renegades are pressing forward here. They do have Mangachu on the Roadhog, which he can play quite well. He's a guy you have to look out for. Him going up against Agilities is going to be an interesting one. Now Immortals starting to engage a little bit as his cart makes its way up. Early Hook goes out onto Man of Snow, and Juvenile goes down right out of the gate as Nami is able to find that frag. So Immortals with the one-player advantage. Renegades now dropping two players as Mangachu goes down. Nami able to find both of those players. Renegades still just looking to back up here, regroup, get their respawns. And they will be coming in, but Grim Reality is on that 76. A very popular pick here on the defensive side of Gibraltar. He's just going to be looking to get on that high ground and really just sit in the back and rain down bullets on the pressing Renegades.
That's such a hard position to deal with, especially when he's getting very close to Attack Visor along with Aethon and a Nano Visor. Look for that to come out sometime in the next fight or two here. Man of Snow already looks like he's starting to address Soldier 76. He's going to have to fly directly up there to shut him down. But as it stands right now, a Nano coming out for the side of Renegades.
That's a really big opening pick for them. That's two for Renegades off the start. They were able to get Aethon and Nami. Agilities returned with one onto Sherlocky, but Renegades are certainly getting the better of this fight. And you still have Agilities who's caught in. He'll be a pretty late kill there, a late respawner will come through from Immortals, and the rest of Renegades are just pressing forward, trying to find any kills that they can, really, on these Immortals players that are staggered coming out of that forward spawn. As they trade back and forth a bit, Grim Reality's going to get the nano boost from Aethon to just try and slow down Renegades a little bit. He is able to take down Juvenile, and now Immortals have quite a bit of ultimates to work with in the bank right now. Four in total for them. And they're going to be now getting up on the high ground to set up their defense. Nice hook off the start from Agilities, but he gets knocked down to the low ground. Biotic set on himself, and he'll actually get taken out by Mangachu. Sound barriers are used. Renegades will pop that off. Mangachu going whole hog, and that will secure three, make that four kills for Renegades, as Jesus had popped off that tac visor as well. Renegades, though, in full flow at the moment through this hangar phase.
Even with that hook pulling into the shuttle, Man of Snow flies up with D.Va to shut down any sort of fire that was going to be coming onto his teammate. Renegades keeping that entire push alive, but Immortals coming back to challenge.
Hyped comes in to stall at least for a little while. They take down Jesus. Grim Reality finds that frag for Immortals, and they might be able to hang on here as they use a self-destruct. Hyped does on the point, just zoning them out. Now Juvenile getting that nano boost, and he wants to wreak a little little bit of havoc on these players on the cart. Grim Reality still up top of the Binger. Shatter comes through from Juvenile. There's a self-destruct there as well. Man of Snow takes out Agilities. And Immortals trying to hang on right here, but it seems as though Renegades might just come out on top of it. Nano Boost is going to go into the hand of Grim Reality as he finds 1-2 for Grim Reality. He's hanging on for Immortals by the skin of his teeth, and that will actually push Renegades back. They found the kills. Immortals will be able to hang on this second point. Good job reinitiating, which really was all started by Hyped.
An absolutely clutch rally there by Immortals, bringing it back, stopping on the second point. If you don't get that stop on the second point, Renegades rolling into the third. They're going to get a lot of distance out of that with how much they still had going for them. Immortals, they have Attack Visor to work with. Nami's working on an Earth Shatter. Verbo, Sound Barrier to shut down Jesus, perhaps. And all of Renegades are pretty low on their ultimates, about 70% at highest.
Grim Reality is going to use the Attack Visor from the back, but immediately, Man of Snow gets onto him to try and shut that down. He does a good job of really negating most of it. Mangachu had gone down from Renegades, and now they lose Sherlocky, so they are three out of it at the moment, as Grim Reality is also able to find Juvenile. And Man of Snow is still in, and if he's not careful, yeah, he's going to be a pretty late stagger. A stagger death on the side of Renegades. Actually, he's able to at least get back into his mech, but Hyped goes down. Not sure exactly how that one happened, but Immortals will be down a player, so have to be careful. They return as they kill Jesus there, so it is a 5v5 at the moment. A bit of an awkward fight on both sides, but Earthshatter comes through from Nami. Sound Barrier. There will be a self-destruct from Renegades, but that doesn't really do anything for them. And they lose three players here. Immortals really solidifying their defense here throughout the hangar phase.
It looked like Agilities was on the rocks there for a second, but a nano landing on him, trying to make sure he kept alive. Perhaps well spent, kind of one of those ones you got to go back and look really closely on. Either way, it worked out for Immortals. They got a second hold here, third hold. And Renegades now with a minute and 20 seconds left on the clock to get through the second stage.
Got a lot of ultimates to work with, though. Five in total, certainly leading in this economy. They need to make this next push work. Renegades, a minute and 10 seconds left. They really need to win one here and cap this second point as they start to engage right now. Sound Barrier will start things off for them. Agility's caught out, will get taken down. Now Jesus using that Attack Visor. He's looking to clean up two for Jesus so far, and he's going to lay out quite a bit of damage on the rest of the Immortals players as he also finds Grim Reality. Renegades getting quite a number of kills right there, and they should be able to get this second point. Indeed they will. So finally getting it right towards the end. It was close, but now just 2 minutes for Renegades to try and get this cart to the final point.
Renegades only with an Earth Shatter to work with here on the final point. Immortals, Grim Reality is going to have Attack Visor as well. Agilities and Nami combining to take down Mangachu there.
Ooh, Jesus was able to find Nami a little late there, and if Jesus isn't, or if, if Agilities isn't careful, he might go down, but he actually manages to squeak out of there. Jesus hanging around just a bit too long, and Grim Reality will take care of him. So the ultimate advantage certainly now in favor of Immortals, but Renegades are pressing that cart forward for the time being. Once it gets at the top of this hill, right here, we will be seeing yet another fight. It should go the way of Immortals. Let's see Juvenile using that Earth Shatter. That might be enough for them as Renegades find one, but now all of the ultimates coming through from Immortals. Pretty much everything except for the whole hog, and that will allow them to get at least three kills, possibly even a bit more, as Man of Snow gets knocked out of his mech. And he's
going to
stagger
him there.
Finally goes down.
What a beautiful fake by Nami, letting down the shield for just a second, getting Juvenile to throw his Shatter down, catching it, returning one back that was far more effective. It's one of those little details to the shield game that other pros will talk about, Nami being one of those Reinhardts, just absolutely great at it.
He's one of the best out there. He's a joy to watch on Reinhardt. Now Agilities is going to initiate. They speed boost and use the whole hog, just pressing Renegades back a little bit, but now they want to come back in. Good hook from Agilities to take down Jesus way in the back line, but Agilities in a bit of trouble now himself as he's caught forward. He might end up getting staggered out here. Already used his hook. There's nothing else he can do. So they trade out one for one right there. Juvenile and Agilities both going down at the moment. Immortals have a pretty strong hold on this defense. There's only 10 seconds left for Renegades to make something happen. Aethon getting hooked in there, that is bad news for Immortals, but still, they need to press forward, get themselves onto this card here, as Mangachu now rushing in with the whole hog and the nano boost, just pressing these Immortals players back. Two kills for Renegades, but Immortals were able to strike back with one themselves as they took down Jerp, but Renegades need to stay on this cart for the rest of the push, and they have two very hurt players here with Biotics on themselves as, well, they're trading still back and forth, two for two, and now Sound Barrier out on the side of Immortals. The Whole Hog is going to press some of those Renegades players back. Juvenile goes down. Nami is just swinging away, trying to get all these bodies off of the cart. And now the Earth Shatter through from Nami as well is going to charge Man of Snow all the way into the back, making sure he is no longer a problem. Two more kills for Immortals right here, and the Nano Boost given to Grim Reality. That will allow them to hold on as they stop Renegades before being able to get to the final point. And now we will go to the change of sides and switch things up a bit.
Pretty solid defense from Immortals starting on the final moments there, the second point. Up until then, it was the Renegade show walking pretty much without any sort of distress, without anybody slowing them down at all through stage one. Just one of those fights that kind of gradually goes in one team's favor, as Renegades looked very well prepared for how they would take that down. First stage, one of those parts of the map that has kind of changed over time. Initially, it wasn't a bad place to mount a hold, but lately, with everybody learning to switch through the server room and just kind of the general positions, once you see a Soldier 76 and how strong D.Va is, starting to kind of tilt the other way, you only see a full hold there maybe once in a blue moon now.
Yeah, it's, you definitely don't see it too often, and if you are able to full hold there, that is certainly a feat in and of itself, but now we will be going into the change of sides, as Immortals will try their hand on the offense. Renegades running a pretty standard setup so far here on their defense. Jesus will be on that 76 yet again, presumably just sitting up on that high ground alongside of Sherlocky. And they'll just try and rain down on them, but I'll see what Immortals wants to bring out on their offensive side. I would expect, obviously, you still have agilities on Roadhog. You can really initiate well for them, get people off that high ground with some of those hooks or what have you. Just
got so many good hooks last round, too.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, some crucial ones, too, and especially being able to find some backline targets who go pretty uncontested throughout. Guys like Jesus, he's sitting all the way in the back, just getting damage out there. Agility is able to find the hooks and take care of players like that. And you got to love it if you're a Mortals fan. But here we go. Immortals now will move to the offense. Grim Reality will be on Zarya this time around as they start off their push, immediately sending three up to the high ground to meet with some of those Renegades players who are sitting there on the high ground. And we're going to see actually a pretty early fight here, it seems. Renegades pressing and trying to keep Immortals off of that high ground there. Nami and Hyped are just sitting up top. Meanwhile, the rest of the Immortal squad pressing the payload forward. Juvenile is a bit forward himself here. Will get slept. Couldn't quite hit the hook. Those agilities almost had a brilliant opportunity to start this off, but they will just continue to come forward here. Juvenile, the first one to go down. Nami might get traded out, though. He's hanging on for dear life and actually gets cleaned up on by Verbo. So they trade out Reinhardt. It'll be a one for one. And Mangachu then goes down for Renegade. So Immortals with the one player advantage at the moment as they continue to duke it out here on the cart. And Immortals not having too many problems here, still pressing forward. And their agility is even finding Sherlocky, Man of Snow. Now Hyped is going to get a nano boost just to make sure they secure this first point. Now that is an easy take for Immortals. Not much resistance from Renegades there at all.
Yeah, only a little bit slower than Renegades got through there, but pretty negligible. It's all going to depend mostly on the second stage is what we're seeing a lot of the time really burn through. Granted, the third stage is also quite tough for an offense to get through all the way here. Immortals are going to be working with close to five ultimates here in the next fight. And Renegades, they've got two online already, but they're a very big two and also a self-destruct to throw into the mix. Immortals right now kind of starting to flex the high ground, but they gave it up. And Renegades Nanovisor, Jesus, he's going to be dropping down on everyone.
Oh, man. Combine that with Mangachu, and they just shred Immortals right there. Verbo started off. He was the first to go down for Immortals in the fight. He kind of got caught on the cart. Renegade dropped onto him, and he was pretty much there by himself, Verbo, and just was easy pickings for the Renegade side on defense. Now they come back up on top of the ship. They take this high ground control, very high ground control, I'll point out, but a few big alts coming online right now for Immortals. They have Earthshatter and just about to have Graviton, so this could very well go in their favor. They just ward off that early self-destruct. Mangachu getting caught quite far in himself. A bit of a disconnect from the Renegade side. They use Sound Barrier, and I don't think they're going to need much else, Immortals, because they have already gotten themselves two kills. Aethon ends up going down, but still, things are looking pretty good for them right here as they are just breezing through this hangar phase as well. Renegades will have another shot at this one, though.
Yeah, that previous fight so one-sided for Renegades that Immortals barely generated any ultimate out of it, but Immortals getting through that with just a Sound Barrier, they're actually going to be holding on to all five as they move into the final part of Stage 2.
Graviton's going to come out on the top left, and the shield was there from Nami to avoid the Earthshatter that came through from Juvenile, but Renegades are striking back here as they've already found three kills to start this fight off, and they should be able to hold on just fine right here as Aethon's trying to get himself out of there, but easily taken care of by Jesus. And it is, it's going to be one in, and it's hyped as Eric, oh, they're going to stagger the crap out of him. Poor guy. He's still sitting there. Finally, Mangachu puts an end to it. But Renegades finally stopping Immortals.
3 minutes on the clock for Immortals to get through Stage 2. They're not in dire straits yet, but they're going to have to get some momentum with pretty much only an Earthshatter here. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, they're going to want to hold on to that and burn probably too much time trying to build up more ultimates to get through this part. Renegades got a nano boost, a whole hog. We've seen them actually pair that together far more often than most teams have.
Ooh, Mangachu went for the whole hog, got hooked back in, but he takes care of agilities, no problem, getting put to sleep. Right there was Juvenile as he had a nano boost on himself. Renegades still finding all the kills right here, no problem so far for them. So they're going to hang on, and Immortals have to regroup. Still 2 minutes and 20 seconds to work through this hangar phase, so they have some time, and they also have that Graviton Surge just about to be online, which will be crucial for them alongside of that Earthshatter in the next fight.
Yeah, self-destruct Graviton would certainly be what Immortals needs to get through the point if they can grab the right amount of people in it and guarantee the Juvenile doesn't block any bit of it with his shield. They have no Zarya on their side, so you can't look forward to any sort of Zarya bubbles to save, but hold that thought. Renegades, Immortals already in the mix.
Oh, that was bad news from Immortals from the start as Aethon got hooked by Mangachu very early on, and that should be a pretty standard hold for Renegades right there, being able to take out Aethon early on, and Verbo himself is getting staggered quite hard here, and there's not really much he can do. Mangachu, once again, will end his misery, but now down to a minute 30 for Immortals. They need to make something happen on this next fight.
I guess on the bright side, that's the character that can speed boost himself back to the team, but still, that's going to be a lot of time. Already down to a minute and 15 from three. Last we spoke about it, Immortals, they're going to be working with five ultimates. They've got to make this one work.
Renegades have quite a few themselves that should be able to stave off some of this push on the side of Immortals. Sound Barrier comes through from Renegades as well as a whole hog, and Jesus will use that TAC visor. Three ultimates expelled from Renegades, and they lose Jesus and Mangachu towards the end of that engagement. Now Graviton's going to come out with the self-destruct being there. It didn't really do all that much, but Immortals still find the kills regardless as Nami comes through with a couple. Grim Reality cleans up Jur, so things now looking pretty good for Immortals. Use their ultimates quite well, and they will be able to grab this second point with just 35. Renegades nearly gonna hold on there as they found two kills late, but Nami's just going in with the Earth Shatters. Screw it for him. Three kills for Nami as Immortals are getting their offense going. They get second. We'll have a minute 45 for last.
A little bit of a nail-biter there as Juvenile was maybe half a second away from dropping an Earth Shatter on that entire heart position, stopping that capture. Immortals rolling in to the final point here. They do have a whole hog, but they're only 70% on nano, and that's the closest thing they've got. Renegades, they've got two locked already, a bomb come on Earthshatter.
Self-destruct coming into the back. Everybody able to avoid that. Agilities, who's very hurt, is able to hang on. A minute 20 for Immortals. They only need to move that card a short distance. Earthshatter came through from Juvenile. Got a lot of players on the ground from Immortals, but no kills came through on the follow-up. They trade one for one so far. Juvenile and Agilities both go down, so it is a 5 versus 5 fight. Verbo gets hooked by Mangachu. That's a big return kill for Renegades. And now attack visor out from Jesus. That should hold off Immortals for the time being. They're still holding holding on this card pretty strong, actually, as they come back with a couple of kills of their own. Earthshatter out from Nami. Got some players locked up in it, and there will be a Graviton Surge out. Sherlock, he goes down, as well as Juvenile. Things are looking much better for Immortals here. Sound Barrier comes through as well. Self-destruct landing in the back, but so many kills now for Immortals. Nobody around for Renegades, and that will be Immortals taking map number one here against Renegades on Gibraltar. Down to the wire, to say the least.
Look like Renegades might have it there for just a second, getting out a Graviton and an Earthshatter from their opponent, but in the end, the rest of Immortals showing up from respawn and really piling it on. Renegades just couldn't hold with the cart being so close to where it was.
No, Immortals, again, able to take the win there, and Renegades just falling to that corner of death on Gibraltar. That just if you can't push it around that, it's just like, I don't think we've seen a single team not be able to push around and then win the match. Like, if you can't make it around the final corner, you're going to lose.
It's a tough section of the map to push. I mean, yeah, the defensive side immediately has high ground, at least while the cart's still moving its way up the hill. So you automatically have that. Plus, the respawn's so close, obviously. So you really have to get a solid team fight win right there to really be able to move that cart forward. And, I mean, you need to string together almost two fights in a row to really be able to cap that last point. So it's very difficult to push. But, you know, in the end, they're Immortals. They didn't need the whole distance, and they were able to grab it. So,
I mean, it's effectively a choke point. It's not a true choke point in that a team has to come through a small area, but they do have to come around a corner. Mm-hmm. And just in general, anytime an offense is able to get through a choke point, they're going to get some distance after that. So when the cart's only made it just a hair around the corner, your big focus there is just win the corner fight, and after that, it should take care of itself.
And it felt like Renegades kind of almost gave up the opportunity to fight when they tried to push back into the second point right after Immortals capped it, and they got just wiped. They got like that whole first distance that they maybe could have held on. I mean, to me, that seemed to be kind of like the clinching moment of the match.
It's a tricky gamble. You can go in there, lose your entire team, and then guarantee that your opponent gets a ton of distance and virtually only has one fight left. At the same time, they gave up so much distance off of that without contesting that it was arguably kind of the same thing. It's just with respawn times and how far they'd have to run back. If they lost that second point, if they tried to contest that and lost, very, very likely it would have been a cap very soon after that.
Mm-hmm. Immortals able to take the win there. Big part of that was Nami. His Earth Shatters were on point as he was able to pick up three with this one. And this is the one I was talking about.
Yeah. He came right out and just laid it down on him. He got really low, too, in the process. But he made it happen. Three kills.
Actually, now that I look at it even further, you might be right, Caleb. That might be a great time. I mean, the gate's got to open. Gate takes quite a bit. You're going to give up some of the territory, but at the same time, that gate probably makes up enough for respawns. Really have to look at the math to see. Mm-hmm. But it's a hard call. It's a hard call. Juvenile locked and loaded with an Earth Shatter. Maybe the whole team should have gone in and just tried to hold it right there because they hadn't made the cart too far around that corner.
No, I felt like, again, Grim Reality's soldier play, especially at the beginning, huge part of what gave Immortals this win, and they were able to him up on the high ground, again, able to wipe them out, and it seems like Renegades doesn't know what to do when Soldier's sitting up on that first bend of the first point.
Well, they're sending Man of Snow after him every time, and Man of Snow, I mean, he's all over him, like white on rice, but at the same time, it's Grim Realities, and it's Soldier 76. Eventually, your defense matrix is going to run out, and eventually, Grim Realities is going to start picking up his kills. I mean, a half of his nanovisor, I think, got shut down, but he can just sprint away. You've only got one boost on D.Va. Soldier, he's just going to burn some time on his ultimate, but he will get away from your defense matrix as long as he's determined enough and nobody else is following it up. So I think Renegades did the best that they could with only one person trying to counter him, and it gets into a crazy situation of how much of an impact you really get out of two, who else, what are you sacrificing to get that? I think it's just a factor of how good the individual play from Immortals is.
Now, map number two will be Hollywood. That's where Renegades have chosen to go. We are not going to have a new map just yet. The maps pool, by the way, is what we've been talking about, is Hollywood, Eichenwald, Dorado, Gibraltar, Anubis, and Lijiang. So those are the maps that the teams are picking from, but we're not going to get a new one just yet. We're going to go back to Hollywood.
It's staying tried and true to the standards that we had from last week. I know coming up we got some new ones, but Hollywood, that's rather interesting. I mean, at least for me in this, I think I would still take Immortals because to me they're playing pretty well at the moment. It was close overall on Gibraltar, but on that same note though, Hollywood, we've seen in the past, Mangachu can do some really mean stuff on Pharah, at least on the first point of Hollywood. Now, will Immortals be ready for that? That's the question. But, I mean, we've seen him do some pretty good stuff there and be really effective for Renegades.
Yeah, I think I'm still going to have to go to Immortals on this one. They were playing exactly how they needed to in the last stage. Renegades looked like they were a little bit off. Unless Renegades has something completely up their sleeve for Immortals going into this map, and that's why they picked it, then it's just going to be Immortals again. I mean, you can put Mangachu on Pharah, but Grim Reality, if he switches to McCree over Soldier 76, I don't think you're going to get any room in the air.
No, we've seen McCree. You call it out. Like, Grim Reality loves to play McCree. Excellent counter to the Pharah. And I believe the situation where we saw them just raffle stomping on Hollywood was against Citizen 7 on day number 2, when they were able to get kind of the 1-0 hold. But I'm pretty sure Immortals will be able to deal with that Pharah better than Citizen 7 was able to.
Yeah, I think you got it dead on right there. They're going to be able to handle it, I think, much easier. They know that it's a thing that Renegades like to do, so at least on the Immortals defense, I think they will be there and ready to go, at least have something in their arsenal that will be able to deal with Mangachu. Though we've seen in the past, even when there is something on the field that can deal with Mangachu, whether it be a Soldier or McCree, he can still make it very effective, but I think Immortals will be prepared for that scenario. Either way, but, I mean, who knows? Mangachu may not even run far.
Hollywood does have. Yeah, we were getting into a lot of analysis about whether Mangachu, assuming Mangachu is going to run Pharah. I think that's a relatively fair assumption, unless Renegades has just changed completely. But there's a lot of terrain on Hollywood, especially on the first point, that you can use to keep Pharah alive, even with kind of minimal healing. And that's how Mangachu has always been able to pay out in the past. I think even against Kungarna, he was able to take out Soldier 76 from a high ground. Just has to be at the right time, maybe listening for a clip reload or counting, you know, how much time Soldier has been firing. You know, one of those little weaknesses in somebody's kits, that's where somebody like Pharah can get on them at the right time, and that's a ton of damage done in short order. And once you know you're going to be way ahead in the DPS per HPS race, then Pharah is just a beast. If you are positive, all you have to do is hit your shots.
So as we get into game, any key players you guys want our viewers to be watching out for in this, if for Renegades to be able to pull the win here?
Well, I mean, I think for one of your big ones, we already talked about him a lot, but Mangachu, I think between him and Jesus, and for Renegades in particular too, I think Juvenile getting a lot of value out of his Earth Shatters too is going to be crucial for Renegades, because we've seen in the past some, I think it was even on Hollywood during our previous group stage, Juvenile had a pretty shaky game on this map, some Earth Shatters that didn't quite connect in some very crucial times. I think it may have been Route 66, but still, for them, I think Juvenile firing on all cylinders, hitting his Earth Shatters will be big for them. And on the side of Immortals, you always got to be looking out for agilities. I think him, Grim Reality, and Hyped, even Nami. There's a lot to look at on Immortals.
I generally like to keep my eye on Nami and the kind of support that goes into the Shield War, because I find that one of the most basic, and also when you really start looking at it, sometimes, not always, but one of the more interesting and compelling parts of a team battle. And on Hollywood, there are so many different dynamics to that. You get a full third-person shot, and you can see there's often two or three fights breaking out individually, and every single one affects another one, which if you kind of just follow one person's perspective, it gets to be pretty difficult to see all the details that went on.
Alrighty, well, it sounds like we're waiting on a player to get into the lobby, and it sounds like, I believe it's Ethan, and he's not here yet, so there's a possibility they might start the match without him, which would change a lot of things if he's not able to. He'd be easily able to show up during the match, but that would change a lot of things.
That's certainly not ideal for Immortals, to say the least, but hopefully they get everything sorted out, because, you know, you hate to see that. So far, Immortals are looking great, and I think Ethan's also a pretty big part of that, other than the couple times where he got caught out by some Mangachu hooks. But granted, Mangachu made some good plays. Ethan's still a very big part of the success of Immortals. I mean, at this point in the game, Ana is the backbone of a lot of these teams. So, you know, you need to have your Ana firing.
Sounds like Ethan's back, so we should be getting into game ever momentarily. We will have a full team fight here. You did predict a 2-1, I believe. So what would Renegades have to do here to be able to force that third game?
Oh, for them, again, I think if they can find a way to get Mangachu going on Pharah, at least first point, I think once you get into the streets phase, they don't really use him on Pharah too much. Generally, teams have a much easier time dealing with him through that section, but I think that'll be big for them, at least on the first point. Renegades will be starting off on the offense, but hey, who knows? Looks like Mangachu so far is showing the Zarya, which I'm just as big of a fan of, because he can play some mean Zarya.
Yeah, I was actually thinking maybe not doing anything that they've kind of become known for in the past, breaking out a new look. Farah, I was actually going to discuss about this in specific. I was very curious what Verbo was going to run, whether it was going to be... Actually, is that Grim Reality playing Lucio in the meantime? So they're still going to get two healers out of it.
He might just be speed boosting him.
He could do it either way. Yeah. But, you know, on a Zen, on a with Symmetra, Symmetra might be, once she gets a shield generator up, if it's a shield generator, which we haven't seen so much of, that certainly can counter kind of the dynamic that Farah brings, and that's a whole nother rocket a lot of the time, which makes her so much weaker than just the 2-3 shot queen that she can be sometimes. Yeah, Grim Reality changing to Soldier 76 here, so also curious to see what Verbo's going to select between Teleporter and Shield Generator if he gets the chance. We're going to find that out. His starting orb and all of his initial turrets getting mopped up very quickly by Renegades, not giving him much free charge there. 10% for Verbo. Make that 18-20. That's not a bad return for the start for Verbo.
And now Renegades looking to press themselves through this choke point, just taking the fight right away, straight on into Nami. They don't want to give them an opportunity to get Teleporter or Shield Generator. But already it's 70% for Verbo. Still no one going down yet. And Man of Snow trying to just pressure Grim Reality on top of the cafe there, who was able to deal quite a bit of damage. Two kills for Renegades coming through. Nami and Ethan both fall. So Renegades off to a brilliant start here. Jesus on the Roadhog cleans up Hyped. And there is a Teleporter up. And at this point, Verbo's just desperately trying to defend his Teleporter and make sure that they can get some respawn. But it doesn't matter. Renegade's getting that first point regardless. And great start for Renegades here.
Absolutely. Renegades seeing Symmetra going in very quickly, not giving them much time to snowball whatsoever. It's kind of a Band-Aid situation. Just rip it off. But also, Renegades doing a great job not tunnel visioning on any real target there. You can see even from Man of Snow's perspective, he took Grim Realities down very low, a situation a lot of people chase after him. Just lets him go, keeps rotating damage, letting whoever Immortals is going to put forward eventually soak down and just winning kind of the DPM war over time there. And now Renegade's looking for a Graviton.
Mangachu coming in with the Graviton. There's a self-destruct there. You gotta be kidding me. Man of Snow just pile driving Immortals into the ground right there alongside of Mangachu's Graviton. That was brilliantly executed on the side of Renegades. Let's take a second look at this one, because this was just about perfect. Mangachu waiting, placing it down at the perfect moment. Man of Snow, precision placement right there. And a full team wipe, and now Renegades looking to continue that forward as there will be a nano boost onto Hyped on the side of Immortals. They traded one for one. Jesus is Whole Hog on the cart, gets hooked back in by Agility, shut down, and that might hold off Renegades for now, but they are certainly making good time off the start of this one. Is Mangachu. Well, oops.
Oops indeed. Yep. Now, not only off that bomb combo did they pick up, what, 4, 5? But also an Earth Shatter from Nami. Nami stepped forward very, very far, trying to engage Renegades and take the pace of the fight back. And Renegades came in right behind, dropped the Graviton, mopped it up, not only getting the wipe, but an Earth Shatter out of Immortals, out of it. Immortals now, they do have their own Graviton. They're going to be looking to repeat that.
A fight coming to fruition very quickly here. Graviton goes down, Jur falls to Grim Reality. 2-3 kills for Immortals. That'll be Renegades going back to the respawn. And maybe even get a little bit of a stagger onto Man of Snow while they're at it. But another good hold coming out from Immortals right there.
That was really important for Immortals. They didn't burn anything other than that Graviton there. And now they're going to have 4 online for their ultimate economy as Renegades starting to respawn here and look for their own chance through the streets phase. A lot of momentum bled out of them, I guess is what I'm trying to get at. Grim Reality with attack visor. For Renegades, they've really only got a nano and a self-destruct. Nothing else to pair it with yet. Juvenile not up on his Earth Shatter. Mangachu, even though that last one was huge, he's only at 63%. He will generate it really quickly, but maybe not quickly enough for this next fight.
Grim Reality in a pretty good position to go for attack visor here. D.Va Mech is down, so there's not really much there to pressure. Immortals with 3 kills, and the nano visor came out. I'm sure that dealt a lot of damage onto those players, allowing the rest of the team to clean up right there. And Immortals looking a little shaky off the start on the defense, but they are really getting it together here throughout this streets phase, and they're going to get yet another stagger onto Man of Snow.
And another tough one for Immortals. as they've are sorry for Renegades, as Immortals only spent Nano and Tac Visor there. That's two big ones, but they're still holding on to three of their own. Verbo now up on a sound barrier. Renegades attack from an unconventional path, and then the Earth Shatter is going to get wasted again.
They did get agilities with it, but Nami was able to stop most of it. He uses an Earth Shatter of his own to knock down some of these Renegades players. One for one trade to get us started, but Immortals now taking a 5v4 advantage in this fight. And Renegades, well, if Hype's not careful, he might go down. He is very hurt. He's got a biotic on himself, but it looks as though he'll be able to hang on. And Nami is just keeping the pressure onto these Renegades players that are caught a bit forward. But now we're down to a minute, just under a minute and 40 for Renegades, whereas they started off this Streets phase with four some minutes. Now down to just a minute and 30 to get this next point. Mangachu getting picked that early is, oh, that's bad news for Renegades, really. Now that's going to kill just even more time.
And look at that. Already, again, another Nanovisor for Immortals. Another Graviton. Nami, he's 62% on an Earth Shatter. He spent it in the last fight there. Renegades, they've got a Sound Barrier, which is pretty much the only thing they can use besides D.Va to try and shut down any of that Nanovisor. If they can find better positioning for Mana Snow to try and shut down what Grim Realities is doing, they might get something out of that, but it doesn't look like it. Grim Realities already holding the high ground. Renegades Nano coming out on both Reinhardts.
Nano speed boost in from Renegades, but as you said, both sides got it. There was a Graviton out from Hype. Didn't really get all that much. Nami is getting eaten alive. Got caught inside of that Earth Shatter from Juvenile. Now 2-3 kills, and a couple more on top of that coming through from Renegades, getting a full team wipe. That's what they needed to get themselves back into this one. Immortals might just be able to get themselves out for one more fight, though, so Renegades are going to have to be quick on the draw here and win this next fight.
Jesus, skipping a gear on that last hook, but hold on here. Nami already getting an Earth Shatter out, but he's not going to connect with anybody.
Oh, self-destruct over top. Another one from Man of Snow secures two kills for Renegades, and they will be able to grab this next checkpoint, getting yet another team wipe on the Immortal side. And there was some swaps. Agilities had done a quick switch to Genji to try and get back to the point he was taken care of. And now back onto the Roadhog. So a minute and 25 is all Renegades have to bring this card home.
So many momentum changes back and forth so far. Renegades starting out hot. Immortals taking all the steam out of them for, what, 3-4 attempts. But Renegades finally coming back, pushing around here the final corner into the third point. Immortals playing very far forward.
Nami got hooked in, and then a biotic on himself will be easy pickings for the side of Renegades, as they now have a three-player advantage. This is good from Immortals, though. I like to see the fact that they're at least going in, dying on the cart to stall it out. I mean, even a little bit. Just, you want to go in and just kill some time by dying on the cart.
As long as it's not a trickle, absolutely.
Yeah.
If you can bring everybody in, get him in. There's nothing to lose. You're either burning
time.
Yeah,
if you're going to die anyway.
You're going to die anyway, especially if you're waiting for them to dump those ultimates. Now, there's a few situations where that's not entirely true, but that right there was not one of them.
And now one kill already for Renegades. They are looking great through this third stage of the map. Mangachu, I thought, narrowly getting caught by that. Self-destruct. Hype actually got Juvenile with it, so they've traded out here, and that respawn from Immortals will be coming back pretty shortly here. Graviton, only Verbo caught in it. Now self-destruct into the back from Renegades. Won't find anything, but gives Renegades a bit of space to press this card forward. A great hook from Jesus, shutting down Aethon, and now there's really nobody around from Immortals. Somebody needs to touch the cart, but nobody could get there quite in time. Nami going for the charge, but oh, just couldn't get there.
0.3 seconds left.
That's big. To be able to have at least that little bit of time left. I mean, that's good. Rather that than getting it in the overtime.
Yeah, that can be the difference alone for Immortals. Immortals getting so much momentum back here in the Streets phase. But Renegade's able to recover just over time, eventually bleeding out a lot of those ultimates and coming up with probably through an underdog fight there near the end. Doing a lot of focusing of Nami is what I'm seeing. Anytime they're able to get Nami playing far forward, they're spending a lot of resources to press the kind of his backline as far away from him as possible and then just immediately turn around and engulf Nami and take him out. From there, capitalize on the rest of the fight.
Yeah, that's huge too. Just because of how big of an impact Nami is for Immortals usually, that if you can get him out of the fight, that's good news if you're a Renegades player or a Renegades fan. Now we do go into the change of sides, and Immortals will try their hand at offense. And so far, Renegades are showing this Symmetra Torb.
to get us kicked off. We'll see. It looks as though they will be sticking on it for now. We've seen some teams try this, and not always a successful setup, but looks as though Renegades wants to go for it on their defensive side. So, and Juvenile, I'm sure, will be switching back over to his Reinhardt once he gets his teams to where they need to be. Yes, there we go. Juvenile back on the Reinhardt. So it will be Symmetra Torb for Renegades on their defense. Immortals so far are showing agilities on the offensive Pharah. It's quite interesting for them. We've seen agilities play some Pharah and have some success with it in some previous matches. So maybe this will be enough for them. Take this first point with speed, but
we're going to find out if that notorious Renegades defense is going to be back for the second wave of our round robin. Mm-hmm. Jur also looking for some early charge turrets, orbs sent out here in the beginning to see if he can catch a little bit off of Immortals. Immortals now nearing the point. Agilities has gotten a good look into the back line. He knows he's going to have to take down that turret. That's going to be his job, probably front and center, once Immortals engages here.
You know, just got to spam that turret out, and the defense major is eating up a couple of the rockets, but in the end, Agility's able to take care of that. Verbo comes around from the alley side and just trying to displace some of these Renegades members. Grim Reality, though, will fall as well as Agility's. They come strike back with a couple of their own. It's actually an even 3-versus-3 fight on the point right here, but who has enough firepower to actually win it? Mangachu got Verbo, and he's got some armor coming up online as well. Hype is still in at the moment. Ethan finished off by Sherlocky, though, and now it's time to get out of there. If you're hyped, he does make it out just barely. But Man of Snow going down late will give Immortals an opportunity to come right back in here.
Yeah, that might have been a mistake. The time was already coming back in Renegade's favor here, but the turret already going down for Mangachu, Juvenile, pressing in. Nami's just going to skate right away from him and try and support.
Mangachu used that Molten Core mainly to keep himself alive as Agilities was really pressing him, and they've traded one for one. Jesus and Agilities are down, so 5-versus-5 at the moment. Nami on the point, really hurt, has a biotic on himself. He needs to get those heals quickly, but finished off by Juvenile. Now the Earth Shatter out from Juvenile, gets a couple on the ground, finishes off Verbo. Grim Reality desperately trying to get out of there, but is mopped up in the end by the side of Renegades. And now that they have all these shields and pieces of armor from Renegades, you know, they got them going. It's going to be tough for Immortals to get through here.
Yeah, the snowball is definitely in full effect for Renegades.
They got a lot of utility to work with. They did not opt for the
Teleporter.
They went for the teleporter, which they're getting a mix of both agilities, though, doing a good job of getting himself all the way into the back. Immortals making sure they take care of that. So teleporter is going to go down. And Jur is quickly working on getting another, but pressured heavily by Man of Snow. And he's taken out Immortals, finding a few kills here to avenge his teammate. 3 kills for Immortals, and there is no teleporter, keep in mind, for Renegades. So they can't get back to the point. Man of Snow, though, is going to keep Renegades relevant in this fight with that self-destruct he's been so on point with so far throughout this map. And it's still a bit back and forth, but you do have a lot of Immortals' bodies on it. And Jesus coming back on Tracer. Agility's made the switch over to Genji. They use a sound barrier to try and solidify capturing this first point. It should be theirs. They do have that player advantage. Agility's and Sherlocky end up killing each other. Molten Core actually used by Mangachu as he comes out, but quickly taken care of. Right there is Renegade's doing a good job of at least stalling this out for a while. And Man of Snow is still in there at the moment. Jesus has even made his way back on Tracer. But Immortals just have too many bodies around, and Renegades inevitably will end up getting this point.
Immortals eventually Immortals. Winning that attrition war, but Renegades mounting a pretty great hold and bleeding a lot of Immortals' offensive time there. On the first point, Immortals already starting to work to take the high ground. They don't want some of what happened to them in their streets phase turning back, but Renegades isn't packing really any hitscan you'd see play from the top. Maybe Jesus for some hooks, but it looks like they're just going to play the low ground in the shield war and try and beat Immortals head-to-head there. Agility still on Genji.
Renegades coming back into the fight. Here comes Self-Destruct into the back. Juvenile wards that off. And
Jesus takes down Hyped first here. So Renegades with the one player advantage. Man of Snow pressing on to Grim Reality. Here comes a Nano Blade out for Immortals as they try and get something out of it, but shut down, at least for the initial part of that one, was Agilities. And they still come through with a few kills. There's only two players up on the card from Renegades, and there will be even be a self-destruct going down on it. Sherlocky desperately trying to get out of there has actually managed to get saved by Mangachu's bubble. Makes it back in time, but Immortals win the fight, and they will continue to press forward. Minute and 45 just about on the clock for them.
Always a pleasure to see Agilities play Genji, even if he does spend part of the time sleeping on the ground. Nami playing pretty far forward into Renegades. Also got Hyped playing Debo pretty far in the back, and Man of Snow, nano boost getting wasted.
Oh, that's really unfortunate for Renegades. Man of Snow gets a nano boost as he was dying. Sherlocky a bit late on the trigger pull right there. There is a sound barrier from Renegades to keep them relevant in the fight, and Jesus, combined with Juvenile, actually able to keep Renegades really in the fight there as they both find a couple of kills, so Immortals back to the drawing board. Certainly, and Juvenile wants to even see if he can get hyped for a late stagger. Ooh, nearly paid for it. But they do want to re-engage. Immortals, they're just about to be up on another nano blade, so keep an eye on that. Here it comes. Agilities going straight into the back. Two kills already for Immortals. Agilities getting one himself. That's a whole lot of pressure to deal with if you're Renegades, and Man of Snow is going to be taken care of here as well. So Immortals pressing forward, 40 seconds for them to get this next point.
That should be enough for them to get it very, very close. Renegades looking like they're going to contest, and they're going to have just enough time to mount. Well, this looks like a four-man defense. Lucio, nope. Lucio might be getting there just in time. This might be a full six. Juvenile coming out from Earthshatter.
Did a lot of damage to Hype, but I think Hype was really the only one that he got inside of it. And there's going to be a self-destruct in the back. Juvenile had no idea what was going on. It just landed right behind him. He had the Biotic on himself. It's a tough situation regardless, but Immortals already have two kills at the moment, so things are looking good. Renegades are still holding on for the time being. As Agilities in just getting those shurikens out, you still have Renegades players stalling this cart out, but in the end, Immortals do get this next checkpoint, a minute and 20 to bring it home.
Immortals gonna be rolling into that final. Whoa, Agilities barely keeping himself alive through that Biotic. Immortals rolling in here into the final point. They are locked and loaded with five ultimates online, and Renegades have none.
Yeah, this is go time for Immortals right here. They have so much in the bank, ready to rock and roll. And as you said, Renegades don't have really a whole lot. The best they can hope for is to get this sound barrier quickly and maybe get that Graviton and Nano Boost a little bit later in the fight. But here comes the Nano Blade out from Agilities to start this one off. He so far hasn't actually found anything. Nami goes down to Jesus. Immortals coming out on the short end of that fight. And Renegades doing a good job holding that off. Aethon getting killed late now. 35 seconds for Immortals.
Immortals perhaps burning those a little bit early. They're going to get defended on this push. 30 seconds left. They're going to have to reform and get back in there. And now Renegades, they weren't quite there on that last offense, but they're going to have four online for this final defense of Hollywood. Immortals, they've only got two to work with. Verbo getting close to a sound barrier. Renegades looks like they're going to take this.
This Earth Shatter's got to be big from Nami. He's got to find value out of this. Graviton comes down. Sound barrier from Renegades. Two kills for them. They might just hang on here on Hollywood. Send it to a third and final map. That's three kills for the Renegades side, shutting down Immortals. It's only Verbo left on the cart, easily dispatched of right there by Jesus, and they should be able to hang on. Grim Reality is back, just stalling as long as he possibly can, but I don't think he'll be able to do it long enough. Nami taking care of Grim Reality gets one as he's still in on that cart. Now coming through with yet another Dragon Blade is Agilities. I mean, he's got to pull off a miracle to make this happen for Immortals. And now Hyped is going to go in with a self-destruct. Immortals players are getting themselves back onto it. Just barely, but Verbo taken down. Eventually, that's got to end. There it is. Renegades are going to send it to a third and final map. Yet another nail biter.
here for the match on Hollywood.
Situation getting so close, Sherlocky chased down Agilis on Genji just to make sure it ended.
Just to make sure they got the kill. And you said it, they will send us to the third map. It's not going to be a 2-0 sweep here. We're going to go see at third map. I am excited. Man, I think this is the first time we've seen many people play Torbjorn on that first point defense. I feel like this is the first time we've seen it actually work.
Yeah, it hasn't been incredibly successful for a lot of these teams, but I mean, they held for quite a while there, and it's good to see it have that kind of success. The Symmetra Torbjorn can be so strong if you are able to get. At that time, they opted for Teleporter, which is another interesting note that so many teams now are going for Teleporter rather than Shield Generator.
In that situation, made total sense.
Yeah.
Keep going.
Yeah, but I mean, either way, you win that first fight. You get the armor up from Torbjorn, you get, whether it be a Shield Generator or Teleporter, they're both good. And, I mean, it's tough to win a fight if you're the pushing team at that point. If they can get some of that early build-up winning the first fight, it's very tough to win the next fights after.
I think one of the things that really kind of describes how Mangachu plays, he was the one that was playing Torbjorn in that instance, but one of the things that kind of describes how he plays is he's very, very good at being intuitive about how the enemy team feels, what they're thinking, what they're looking for, and where they want to go. And if you have a player like that on Torbjorn, that turret's always going to be in a place it shouldn't be. He's always going to be crouching behind something and popping off a shotgun exactly when you don't want him to be there, like coming in from the high ground when you're playing Roadhog and your hook's out, and he just puts like three in your face, and then there's a turret up there in the high ground. He can just constantly be a problem. He knows what you want, and he knows how to break it down, and that's a characteristic that's going to make a Torbjorn player certainly much better, but overall it was all of Renegades working with that setup to make it as effective as it was.
It was, and they were able to hold on defense, send us into the third game. A big part of their offense, though, Man of Snow. We saw two fantastic ults from him, one of them blind here, just trusting his teammates on the callouts and is able to pick up two.
Ah, oh, man, there was so many instances in that match where Man of Snow made huge self-destruct plays time and time again, and whether it be a blind ult or combining it with Mangachu, what have you, Man of Snow really came up big for Renegades multiple times with his self-destructs. I mean, two kills, even the zoning power of a self-destruct can be great on its own, but Man of Snow was finding kills with them time and time again. It was, I mean, I can count at least on one hand where, you know, he didn't get any kills with his self-destruct. It seemed like he was always finding something, and that's really good for them, giving them that player advantage.
And to touch on two players you don't necessarily always kind of talk about, the guy who often plays Lucio and a Reinhardt. Juvenile probably doing a great job giving kind of call-outs and explanations of what's going on with Nami, because Renegades was able to find Nami and take him down quite a bit throughout that set. But Jur playing Symmetra on that first point, if you're paying attention to where he was putting his shields, the E-shields, they were just constantly in the wrong place at the wrong time for Immortals.
Able to get in the way, and we will go to map number 3. Eichenwald is where Immortals wants to go, and that's where we will have our third and final deciding map. Finally get a new map here. I am excited. Going to Germany. Let's go.
Yeah, man, I love it. I'm excited to see it. Obviously, we haven't seen too much of Eichenwald recently, so we'll get a bit of a change up here. We don't have too much history to go off of with these teams on this particular map, so it's something a bit fresh. And it's a hell of a map for a third and final one, that's for sure.
This map's always interesting to me, so I'm excited about this, especially with these two teams.
Absolutely. Yeah. Here we go.
All right, let's get into it, folks. Third and final map between Immortals and Renegades, two of the top teams here in the Overwatch Winter Premiere. They've had a slugfest here so far and quite a long round of fisticuffs, but this will come down to Eichenwald to decide the victor on this one, as it will be Immortals on the offensive side to get us kicked off. Renegades will be on your defense. And Man of Snow's just going to, he's just going to run, jump right down into the river, go for a swim. Get us kicked off, but we'll see what they want to do on defense. Of course, May can be very strong here. You have so many options on Eichenwald, really. There's a lot of different things you can do on this. I don't know. Thanks,
why
Renegades.
Not? Yeah,
why not?
That's all I have to say about it. Why not? A little bit of fun with it.
Thank
I wouldn't
you.
Be surprised to see Symmetra stay here on the defensive side for Renegades. We've seen that a few times. I mean, we've even seen Bastion throughout the AF. We want to keep reaching back into the past. We've seen Bastion on Eichenwald, and I've seen it win.
Oh, yeah.
Big time.
Yeah, there's a lot of wacky strats you can pull out.
on this map on offense and defense. So I'm very, very excited to see in the end what they go with. Looks like Renegades are going to be going.
Oh, that's
a big
nasty.
Biotic.
19% for Sherlocky right out the gate.
That's a big biotic there, my friend. And here it is, Immortals on the offense. They have agilities on Genji, Grim Reality on the Tracer. It is a dive comp out for Immortals. They don't want to give Renegades any shot at stopping them inside of that choke. They are just walking right in, but Renegades have a quick response. They got two kills, but Immortals coming back with a couple of their own, and that walk back is so quick. If they can manage to find a few more here, yes, Immortals have gotten three. There's only a few bodies left on this point. Agility is getting melted.
That's not a 1v1 you want.
Oh, no. Symmetra will destroy Genji any day of the week for the most part. Immortals, though, getting quite a bit of time down on this first point right here, and that is... That's a pretty easy take for them. I mean, you have Juvenile and Mangachu both coming back in on some heavy artillery, but I can't imagine they'll be able to hang on for too long here with the amount of Immortals players that are sitting on this point. Quick first point take for Immortals.
All the goals for the composition of Renegades, when you've got Mei and Symmetra, they all went out the window very quickly there as Immortals just piled through, didn't give him any chance to put the ice wall up or cause any real problems, focusing down Mangachu. Now they're going to be rolling into the second stage, and right now Immortals already working on taking the high ground away from the second stage, and the high ground on this stage of Eichenwald is just such a huge factor.
Yeah, there's a tremendous high ground to be had here. Sherlocky using the nano boost will be given off, and so far, Renegades are pressing quite deep into them, onto this cart, and there will be... I mean, it will be at least a sound barrier from Immortals to defend, and they are really hanging on right here. Four kills for them at the moment. Renegades really just trying to stall. Jesus is running around on the cart. It's good. I mean, at least he goes to die on the cart, but Renegades playing very, very aggressive right there.
Immortals. It was kind of a dive comp. Winston changing off. I guess it was a full dive comp now that I look at it a little bit more closely. Changing in the middle of that fight there, and right now, Agility's going to be having a Dragon Blade on his side. Ethan, he's got his Transcendence. Renegades, they're holding on to the top of the castle here, and that's going to be hard for Immortals to get through. Immortals breaking out that Dragon Blade.
Agility's out with it, does find Sherlocky, and the Transcendence was used by Ethan to keep his Genji alive. Originally had a Biotic on himself, but it wore off right in the middle of that Dragon Blade, and Immortals are finding a whole lot of kills right here. It's only Man of Snow left on the cart, and he is taken care of quickly by Nami. So Immortals in full flow at the moment on their offense of Eichenwald here.
They did burn a lot of ultimates to get through that stage, but Grim Reality is going to have a Pulse Bomb pushing here into the final part, crossing the bridge to capture the second point. Renegades, they're going to put up their own defense. They're going to have an Earth Shatter and a Self-Destruct rolling out.
There is a Pulse Bomb ready for Grim Reality. Just looking for his target. He's going to stick it on a Mangachu, and it actually collateral damage. It killed Sherlocky. Mangachu got the bubble on himself, and there is going to be still a lot of Immortals players on this cart. They've managed to find quite a few of the Renegades, and Immortals are just cruising. Grim Reality goes down, but they try to come back out and contest this cart. They managed to get it just in the nick of time. Renegades are there, and there's going to be a Graviton. They might just be able to hold on right here. They did get a couple of kills to start it off. Nami falls. And it is going to be Renegades holding on. I mean, that is about as close as you can get to that next checkpoint being capped.
Just in time, Mangachu throwing out the Graviton in order to round up all of Immortals and wipe them off. Juvenile being disciplined enough to even hold on to his Earth Shatter, so they stand a chance of doing it again. Earth Shatter on the bridge phase is just even more deadly than it is already. There's basically two real avenues to come in from, and Shatter can shut them both down.
Yeah, that is a huge ultimate. Specifically for this one, Juvenile going forward with his Earth Shatter. They take it aggressively into Immortals. Two players go down, and they are looking to continue to pile this on. Nami with four in the middle of that one. My goodness, that is a full team wipe for Immortals. Disastrous for Renegades. They played an aggressive. Juvenile got a decent Earth Shatter in, but Immortals are the ones with the last laugh right there as they continue to just press aggressively to the Renegade spawn on this last point. They are very far in at the moment, just getting all the free cart time that they can. Oh my.
Now Nami is going to be looking for a final Earth Shatter. Self-destruct for Hype. Grim Reality is got another Pulse Bomb and Aethon with a Transcendence. This is a lot of tools to push into Renegades, and they've only got two to defend with.
Pulse Bomb came out, self-destruct in, hyped, getting Juvenile. Those are two big kills for Immortals. Nami ended up going down, but they are still pressing the issue here. Three versus three fight. That Renegades respawn is so close, though. Grim Reality getting a couple of kills right there, and they even take down Jesus to finish things off. So Immortals with a still pretty strong presence on the cart here. There is a sound barrier out from Renegades. And now there is going to be, oh, that Dragon Blade, and that sound barrier wore off at the end of it. So Agility is really able to press some damage in to the side of Renegades. Ends up going down to Sherlocky, but still it is Immortals cruising. Jesus has that Pulse Bomb. He needs to get something with it. But he will go down before being able to do so. Grim Reality fell as well. That Renegades, those respawns, they're coming through strong. And now, oh, I think Lucio got Jar gets the boost. And he'll just be sitting in the back with that one. A bit of a misfire out from Sherlocky. Now coming forward with the Graviton was completely eaten by Hype, though, and they will get nothing with that. Sad, very sad for Mangachu as he is wishing he could have that one back, certainly. And Agilities cleans up on those Hurt Renegades players. And now, pretty good opening for Immortals. But, I mean, as soon as they get some kills, that respawn is just so close for Renegades. They need to get a team wipe and quickly on that. As they just try and buy time right now for the respawners. But that is a big Earth Shatter coming through from the side of Immortals. Nami got quite a few bodies down on it. The only follow-up was onto Mangachu, though, as they just continue to have a very scrappy fight here on this cart. Agility's getting it done, though, for them in the end. Two kills, actually three for him as Immortals cap it off. Minute 19 left in the time bank overall. It was a pretty tough final push for them, but they got it done.
Interesting tactic there by Renegades. They were staggered on the final point for quite a while, and a lot of teams kind of focus on the card and try and stall out. When it gets very, very close to cap, right there, Renegades, as soon as they started getting staggered, knowing that if they kept trickling in, trying to focus on winning and killing people, that cart would actually automatically just start walking in. So instead, they didn't worry so much about killing Immortals as they did about just keeping the cart static and not letting it move forward and waiting for that moment where they had five or six on the field to really re-engage. And they dragged a lot of time there, and as soon as they had as many people as they could, they piled it back on and pressed Immortals all the way back out, bled at least a minute or two off of Immortals.
Yeah, that was, I mean, great for Renegades in that scenario. They were able to kill a lot of time.
You usually don't see that until it's right about to get capped.
Yeah,
and they did it at a very interesting spot. Noticing that they were staggered is what I saw.
Yeah, I mean, they always seem to get themselves just enough kills to keep themselves in the fight, really, until that final moment. They had always gotten at least a few, so by the time those respawns came back out, they had numbers advantage just because of how close the respawn of Renegades was. And Immortals, in the end, they strung together a lot of kills, which allowed them to really gain ground with the cart and have the advantage in the fight in terms of numbers, even when the respawns came through. But it will be a minute 19 left in the time bank.
Man of Stow still finding a way to kill himself before the match starts. Admire the dedication.
Yep. You gotta admire it. Thank you, Renegades. Thank you for your service. Well, here we go. Immortals now on the defensive side, and it will be Renegades on the offense. Running the offensive, McCree. Pretty relatively standard setup for Renegades on offense. And it's pretty much the exact same thing on the side of Immortals for the defense, minus the Zarian Roadhog changeup. It's the only difference in composition here, but Jesus on this backside. They make their way in through the choke pretty quickly, and Agilities might actually be caught out here. Oh, a lot of damage is put onto him. Really needs to get some heals from his Ana, and Jesus just looking to wrap around this backside here. Gets the fan! Couldn't quite secure the kill onto Grim Reality. That's... Oh, he wishes he could have that one back, I'm sure. And Renegades losing three players. They'll just have to go back to the drawing board and regroup for another fight.
Now, sometimes fan doesn't work out if you don't lead with just a little bit of a headshot.
Yeah.
Immortals pretty much wiping all of that as soon as they were able to shut down Jesus. Both sides running McCree here. It's been a while since we've seen a classic showdown.
I know. Good to see it.
Renegades, they do have a nano boost to work with. I'm probably going to throw that on Man of Snow.
Hype is Going to go in and initiate, displace some of those Renegades players. He even gets the nano boost from Aethon, but two kills here from Immortals. Renegades are striking back with some. It's a 4v4 fight for now. Oh, Sherlocky getting a bit aggressive himself, but Immortals are able to come back with the kills enough to hold on. Man of Snow is still in. He's going to lay that self-destruct out, zoning them, and he actually manages to get a kill with it. His hype was still caught on the point, so Renegades buying themselves time. They get back to the point, but still you have Immortals players trickling through. Agilities and Nami are both there. They're looking to come back through. Grim Reality with a Deadeye from up top gets slept. He took out Verbo. Jesus took out Verbo, I should say. Now a self-destruct from Hype will find two, and that is going to be enough to allow all of the Immortals players to get back and hold on. Renegades getting one tick, but in the end, Immortals really able to pull through. And Man of Snow getting staggered yet again. This guy's had a rough day getting staggered.
For a second there, it looked like Renegades was going to weather through that accidental boostio and be able to roll into Streets phase, but actually it started adding up, and over time Immortals able to hold. It's going to be one of those things you look back on.
Yeah, that is not an ideal situation, to say the least. And Immortals now getting pressed a bit as Renegades get ready to come through.
Another nano almost on their side along with an Earth Shatter. Renegades looks like they could be able to take this one, and this is the one they're going to want.
Oh, that Jesus saves.
Oh, nice.
Sherlocky right there. Big Earth Shatter as well. Sound barriers used on both sides. Juvenile is going to get the nano boost, pressing into Nami, able to take care of him, looking for a bit more as Juvenile picks up three kills for Renegades to steamroll through this point. And that will still be hyped in, but I should be. Yes, will be taken care of rather quickly there. So Renegades pulled out in the end. 3 minutes and 20 seconds to move through the streets.
Juvenile walking straight through Immortals on that one. And Earth Shatter to shut down a charge, followed up by a nano at close range in a boxed room. It was a bad turn of events for Immortals. Juvenile almost already back up on Earth Shatter just because of that one fight.
Oh, I mean, he was just shredding people. Juvenile charging Grim Reality. Two kills for Renegades. Make it three. Juvenile ended up going down, but a big numbers advantage for Renegades at the moment as they continue to clean up on the Immortals players. And they will press forward still. Juvenile, as you said, he's got that Earth Shatter now locked and loaded, and a Graviton on top of that. A lot of deadly combinations available for Renegades now.
Yeah, that self-destruct Graviton. Immortals, they have a Graviton of their own, but they're going to have to pair it with an Earth Shatter if they really want to get big effect, unless Hype can just find the backline on his own. We've seen that many times. Hype can certainly do it. Immortals going to drop in from above, but they're going to get Graviton.
And here comes a self-destruct as well. Man of Snow finds yet again two kills off of the self-destruct and Graviton combo. And Renegades are just looking great at the moment, pressing. And they have not really had too much trouble in this Streets phase at all. Immortals being pressed back 2 minutes to get this next checkpoint, but Immortals looking to re-engage here as finally they get those respawns up. And actually they're going to get Jesus slept over there, and he's taking care of Deadeye in the back from Grim Reality. Man of Snow pressing that defense matrix into him, make sure he can't get anything with it. And I did hear an Earth Shatter come through as well from Nami, and it will be Immortals striking back here and picking up all the kills. So Renegades, they gotta go back, regroup, and go for another push here with a minute 20 left.
Nice recovery from Immortals. Grim Reality breaking out the Deadeye, zoning a lot forward, and in a way forcing Man of Snow to come challenge him. Eventually, that play cost Man of Snow the mech and thus his life. So either way, I guess you could say Grim Reality was able to find one with that Deadeye, but that's one of the big effects of Deadeye is not so much the initial kill, but just the threat of it if you give up a single inch. Agility's rolling out with a whole hog and a nano boost.
He will do quite a bit of damage, and Earth Shatter comes out on the side of Renegades. Juvenile sending that in and will at least secure one. They take down Nami. Yeah, now a couple more on top of that. Well, Mangachu with two himself, as he did get nano boosted, but he's just trying to get Hyped out of the mech for the time being, and Hyped will send that self-destruct in. They don't have, they didn't have the shield there to guard from it. Mangachu is the last one in. Immortals are able to hold on right there. Yeah, that's a good self-destruct out from Hyped. And now down to the final seconds for Renegades.
20 seconds left for Renegades. They do have three ultimates to push in. They do have a bomb combo, so that might be everything they need, but they've got to touch the card in the next 15 Immortals. They've only got Deadeye on their side.
Oh, man, if there was ever a time for Deadeye coming huge. Four Immortals. Sound Barrier is going to start it off for Renegades as they need to win this fight to win the map. Nami goes down first. That alone might be enough for Renegades, but they need to find the rest of these kills. All right, here. Mangachu still has that Graviton. Grim Reality with the Deadeye takes out Jesus. Here comes the Graviton in from Renegades, as there is a lot of follow-up to come through off of that. Agilities and Verbo go down. You still have Nami and Hyped left on the cart for the time being, but there's just so many Renegades players there that they're not going to be able to stave that off, and they do get that next checkpoint, but only a minute and 30 for last. Renegades had to use quite a bit to make sure that they secured the fight, but at least they win it nonetheless.
It did generate quite a bit as well. Renegades able to keep their dream alive on Eichenwald, and for this series here against Immortals, it's 1-1. Renegades, they hold their own life in their hand. They've got to push it all the way to completion. They're already behind Immortals time, but that's an afterthought right now. Mana Snow getting pulled all the way into Immortals.
Yeah, Renegades, they don't care at this point. As long as they finish the map, Renegades, they'll be happy.
But Shatter.
Yeah,
that could cost them.
Yeah, Shatter connected with nothing for Renegades, and that's one of those times where you really needed the Earth Shatter to come through. Nami gets an Earth Shatter off of his own. Got quite a few Renegades players on the ground so far. Juvenile, the only one to go down. Grim Reality got nano boosted himself, took out Man of Snow, and he's dealing quite a bit of damage to Jesus, who has a nano boost, but he is continuing to press forward. Agility's taken out by Jesus. Renegades trying to send this into the history book. 30 seconds left for them, still waiting for some respawns. Hyped is in the back. There will be a sound barrier used from Renegades as well, but they need to make something happen off the back of that. Hyped is going to be caught in behind them. Mangachu using the Graviton Surge, getting quite a few Immortals players inside of it, and he's got a lot of charge to go along with it. Look out, because he is hunting down those supports. In the back, one connects with Ethan, and this might just be it for Immortals. Renegades coming in here, final seconds. Oh, it does go into overtime, so they won't get that extra attempt, but still, as long as they can cap it out, they'll give themselves life. There is a self-destruct on the cart. Mangachu holds on for Renegades, and now those respawns from Immortals come out. Grim Reality switching himself over to Mei to just try and stall this one as long as he possibly can. Sherlock, he went down to Nami, so they are still duking it out on the card here. Two kills for Immortals as they have the player advantage. Make that another one. Mangachu takes down Ethan, but I think this one is going to go the way of Immortals as they're coming out on top in the numbers game at the moment, but Mangachu and company still in at the moment, but oh, it will be Mangachu going down. Jur is still there, finally finished off by Nami, and that is going to be Immortals barely, just barely taking it over Renegades in the third and final map. Well, it doesn't get too much closer than that. The respawn advantage just a bit too strong.
A bit too strong, and Immortals is able to hold on. First time in Overwatch Winter Premier history that we've had this map score of 3-2 every single map for three maps. So, just a fun fact there. Hey. Like you said, close game every single game.
Oh, that was one of the better matches I've seen in a while. I mean, like you said, every single game was close. It kept us on the edge of our seats for sure. Hopefully it did for everybody at home, but that was some good Overwatch right there. Good way to start the day, nonetheless.
And Renegade's able to barely keep it alive as they push through each point, almost wiping, or almost losing a few times there, ultimately not able to push it in on the final point. Immortals, conversely, they plowed all the way through to the final point where they lost most of their time. A final point on Eichenwald being such a problem with the spawns so close.
Yeah.
If you don't get a full team wipe or teams really stagger, it's going to happen. It's going to keep going on.